You're going to have to dry out, Kay. You don't need me to tell you that.
I don't think I can. Look, I've tried before. I thought I was going to die.
Blood everywhere! Take a look for yourself.
Hey, you, come on, wake up there, come on, hey, come on, wake up.
How?
Just a minute, young man. You and I are going to have a little talk.
You a copper or what?
I'll ask the questions, right?
How you stand it, Jude? Is it always like this?
Well, I must admit it's a bit fast and furious since I came back.
But you take it so calmly. You knew how awful it was, but to have to come back, I couldn't do it.
You could if you wanted to keep on breathing, huh?
Don't suppose you know who stuck this in my bed, do you, Bright?
Let's see now. It was probably someone who thought you were a little bit lonely without your good pal, Phyllis. Well, come on, why don't you hit me over the head with it? I hear you do a very professional job.
Listen, Bryant, don't push me. I might just take you up on it.
She's a little upset over a lump of clay, don't you think?
Listen, Bryant, I'd be very careful if I were you. You haven't got Parker and Desmond to back you up now. It's just you and that tin heart, and that's a pathetic combination. So you lay off. You might end up in hospital with Mitchell.
And Hunt.
Oh, hell.
Exactly. That's what it's going to be for her by the time I'm finished.
Well, for a smart operator, you're really pretty dumb, aren't you? When you break in here, you get a chance to take off with the loot, and you go to sleep on the job.
So what are you going to do about it, copper?
I'm a prison officer, not a policewoman. Now, I think it's time you turned your pockets out.
I didn't steal nothing. Just wanted something to eat. For me and Nicky.
Why don't you go home and get something to eat?
Because I haven't got one. I cleared out, and I'm not going back.
You don't seem to be managing too well on your own.
We'll be okay.
Not if I turn you over to the police, you won't.
You're going to call the cops.
Well, what do you expect me to do? You've run away from home. You've broken into my house.
Don't, please. I wasn't going to steal nothing, honest. And the cops will put Nicky in the pound or shoot him, for sure. I'll just take off. I won't break in nowhere else, honest.
All right. Sit down. You and I have got a lot of talking to do. Now, are you going to tell me where your parents live? Pretty funny looking dog you've got.
Maybe we shouldn't have come. The guy might be away.
He was at the fete, Kay. Besides, we've got no choice. Every cop in town's on the lookout for me. Listen.
What if it's not him?
I know the sound of that ute. It's older than he is and not nearly as fit.
Thank you.
fine.
I'm sorry about this, Wall. I tried to contact a couple of mates at the PRG, but the cops got there first.
How are you, kiddo?
Okay, thanks.
Well, where do we go from here?
Well, I've told Alan to stay right out of it. That applies to you too. Well, I need a safe place to help Kay dry out. I thought you might have some ideas, and then we'll get out of your hair.
Well, I am mining a mate's place. It's just over the hill. Reckon we'd be safe there.
What's this we?
Well, come on. Cold turkey's no fun. And I'm not just thinking about Kay.
Look, Wally, I don't want you involved.
Look, will you listen to me for a minute? You've spent most of your life helping other people. It's time somebody returned the favour. Come on.
Well, Winter, and how are you settling in?
Be a lot better without screws barging in all the time.
You tell me you've been at Wentworth before.
Yeah, that's right. Hasn't changed, still a pig hole.
I thought they brought in a lot of changes since you were here last.
So what? Still stir, innit?
Got a point there.
Anyhow, what makes a bloke like you want to work behind bars? Can't be the bickies, they pay peanuts.
You ever heard of job satisfaction?
You'd have to be kinky. You look all right to me. There must be something I can do to make the job a bit easier for you.
Well, what have you got in mind?
Well, let's just say you was having eye trouble. And you just didn't happen to notice a certain few special items I might be bringing into the place. You could buy a lot of very expensive glasses with the things you'd get.
You must think I came down in the last shower, Winter. Barnhurst sent us a pretty comprehensive report on what you've been up to. You can forget the drugs racket here. And now we've finished our cozy little chat, let me remind you of something. Next time you try and bribe an officer, I'll slap a charge on you so fast, you wonder what hit you.
You sure it's okay for us to stay here?
Oh, sure, yeah. Mike's overseas. Won't be back for a couple of months. Hey, Kay, you're forgetting your tea. It's getting cold.
I don't want it. I feel rotten.
Probably because you haven't eaten for so long, love. Why don't you try a sandwich or something?
I'm not hungry. Look, I feel pretty beat. Is there somewhere I could crash?
Yeah, the bedroom's right through there. Take your pick.
Thanks, Wally.
There you go. And don't wait for me. I'm going to put Nicky outside.
Why?
Well, I think that might be a wise move, considering all he's had to eat. And don't worry, he can't get out of the yard.
Oh, dear. The duck up.
There. So, how long have you been away from home?
4 days, counting today.
Well, how'd you eat?
Just a bit of fruit. Bloke bought me a hamburger. Only...
Only he wanted his money's worth, eh?
Yeah. I'll give him the slip, though.
Surely home's better than starving on the street. You know, they must be getting pretty worried about you by now.
It's only me dad, and he couldn't care less.
Well, where's your mother?
Got sick of dad bashing her up and took off. Now I cop it even worse.
He beat you?
And how? He comes home full and starts belting into me for nothing. Now, he broke Mum's arm once, and last time he put her in hospital. She never came back. I'm not lying. He got stuck into me the other night. Reckon he'd have killed me if I hadn't have grabbed Nicky and taken off.
You want me to get you some more?
Nah. God, I'm bust.
Well. What are we going to do with you now?
We'll be okay. Nicky and me will sleep where we did last night.
Where's that?
in one of them community bins. It's pretty good. There's plenty of old clothes in there to keep warm with.
I think I have a better solution than that.
You're going to dub me in?
We'll talk about it in the morning. You can stay here tonight.
You won't ring the cops while I'm asleep.
I promise. Now, I think you better have a bit of a scrub up before you go to bed.
Can I bring Nicky in? He's used to being with me. He might get scared.
Is he house trained?
Oh, yeah.
All right, go and get him.
Nicky! Come on, Nicky!
Come on, Marlene, you're holding everyone up.
Oh, yeah, all right.
You're going in, all right?
Oh, give us a minute, will you?
Shut it, Bright.
Blood, doesn't it? Is that what Phyllis's head looked like when you bashed her then?
Huh. I know what you're trying to do, Bride. Now let me out of here.
No way. It looks like blood, doesn't it? Maybe you like the sight of blood. Is that what it is? What'd you do, bash her head until her face was all covered in blood, huh?
Shut up, will you? Just shut up! I didn't mean to hurt her that bad. I didn't. All right. What you wanted to hear. Let me out of here, Bride.
Sure.
Feels pretty good, eh, fella? You smell real nice now.
Well, didn't expect to see you up this early.
Reckoned it was time I gave Nicky a bath. Yeah. He looks real good when he's clean.
I still don't reckon he'd win any first prizes, but it is an improvement. Who, paid for his registration?
I did. I sold papers for a bit and got enough to get Nicky his rego on disc, in case he ever got lost.
You fed him yet?
Yeah. I only gave him the scraps from last night and a couple of biscuits.
Oh, is that enough?
Oh, yeah, he's fine. I'll put him outside now so I can get real dry.
All right.
Come on. I used an old towel. Found it outside.
Here. You help yourself and I'll put some coffee on. There you go.
Hey, I like this stuff. Mum used to buy it.
Listen, I've been thinking. Why don't you stay here today while I'm at work? And then when I come home, we can talk things over.
You mean it's okay to stay in the house while you're not here?
Yeah. But I do expect it to be a lot tidier than it was when I got home yesterday.
I'll clean it real good for you. Hey, is it okay to have more of these when I finish?
What about a couple of boiled eggs instead?
I like them better fried.
Oh, well, I think I can manage that.
I like them turned over the best.
Oh. Morning, Heather.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Morris. Is there something wrong?
Oh, we just found out that it was Keane who bashed Phyllis Hunt. Funny, I didn't think she was the type. At least it lets Cass off, that's something.
Is it always so violent?
No, not all the time. Seems to run in cycles. So you can never afford to let up.
Oh, God. Maybe Miss Ferguson's right. Maybe I don't have what it takes.
Has Joan been giving you a hard time?
No. Oh, well, it's just that I thought you'd need to show a bit of humanity in this job, try and win the women's confidence. But it sort of backfired on me. I think most of them have sized me up as being pretty dumb.
Oh, nonsense. They test every new officer. It's just routine.
Yes, but it was only a gag someone played on me. It made me look a real idiot in front of Miss Ferguson. I didn't think a mate would do that.
You know who did it?
Yeah.
And you didn't tell Joan?
No. Was that wrong?
No, not if it was a joke. I mean, knowing Joan, she would have slapped on a hefty charge and you would have had an enemy for keeps. Well, it sounds like you're doing fine to me. And don't let Joan intimidate you. She does that to every new officer. You soon learn to roll with the punches.
I hope so. I really want to do this job well.
Well, let's broaden your education a bit. I've got to do the rounds in B block later. Might be an idea to join me.
Okay, by me. But all the other blocks would be pretty much the same, wouldn't they?
Well, not really. We've got the big problems in this block.
Well, you've sold me. That'll make a nice change.
Right. How about a coffee before muster? Joan's not on till a later shift, so you can stop looking over your shoulder.
Oh, I hit it. You sit.
Right.
How would you like it?
I thought Kay'd be in for a rotten night, but she wasn't too bad at all.
Oh, it'll get rough. Don't kid yourself about that.
Yeah, I know. I've seen it before.
Oh, yeah, but this time it's your daughter. Look, I'm sorry I wasn't able to do anything to help before you took such drastic action.
Yeah, well, I've been thinking about that, Wally. I mean, your association with Anne and all that, I mean, you're putting yourself on the other side of the fence helping Kay and me.
Well, I wouldn't be here if I didn't want to be.
Still, we put you in a spot turning up on your doorstep like that.
Yeah, well, I suppose Anne will look on it as if I'm letting her down, but I keep telling myself if she was in my position, she'd be doing just what I'm doing.
Yeah. She's one hell of a lady, all right. She really stuck her neck out organising that fate for us. I don't blame her if she feels bitter about me using it to make the break.
Well, look, there's no use putting yourself through that. You did it for Kay. She's still your number one priority.
I'm scared, Wally. Oh, basically, she's a good kid. She knows she's got to kick the habit. But I sometimes wonder if she's got the guts to go through with it.
We can try.
What if something goes wrong? What if she doesn't make it?
Fisher, Coombs, Lana, workshop.
Excuse me a moment, Miss Rogers. King, the governor wants to see you.
Oh, how's Bobby, Mrs. Morris?
She'll be back later today.
Oh, great.
Oh, let's get on with it.
That's enough, Winter.
Meet you in the rec corridor and Bean about 10 minutes.
Oh, great. Yeah.
Come along, King.
I hope they throw the book at you.
Okay, here we go. Bryant, Milsom, Warren, Winter, Anderson, Jones, Stacy, Laundry.
Hooray, she made it.
Oh, can it, Winter? You're about as funny as leprosy.
Okay, everybody, move out.
Marlene, what are you doing?
I've got to go.
I wanted to ask you something.
What?
Why didn't you put me in about the sauce?
Well, because I knew it was just one of your stupid jokes. But no more, please, Marlene. Miss Ferguson's making life tough enough as it is.
Yeah, she's the pits, all right. She's got it in for me too, eh? Look, you and Meg will have a few laughs, take it down a peg or two.
Marlene, Miss Ferguson is an officer. So am I. So cut the jokes.
Oh, I thought we were mates.
Oh, we are. Look, it's just that I've got a job to do, and I'm going to do it well. And I don't need you making things harder for me, okay?
Okay, okay. Your hem's down.
Just kidding. See you later.
Mr. Munro?
If you're from the bloody Salvos, I don't want to know.
No, I'm not, Mr. Munro, but I do want to talk to you. That's your son.
That stinking little bludger. What are you? The truant officer or something? It's your bloody job to see he goes to school, not mine. Now get the hell out of here. You're trespassing.
Look, Mr. Munro...
And don't bother coming round here again. I'm fed up with you lot. I said bugger off!
Sorry, I got held up.
It's okay. What happened to Keane?
Well, for the time being, she's in solitary. Tomorrow...
What is going on?
Come on!
Whatever is this?
Come on!
Oh, God, got it started.
Get out! Come on! Cut this out!
Serves you right for making fun of my ass, right?
Are
you
okay?
Yes,
alright.
Just come on, come on. You lousy mole. You started it. Kick your bloody head in first chance I get.
So it sounds like the freak's giving Buck a pretty rough trot too. I mean to say, how rotten can you...
Will you shut up for a minute, Rabbit? I'm trying to get some information here on Myra.
Full details in our next bulletin at
midday.
Oh, damn it. Now, you see, I've missed it.
Oh, no news is good news, Jude. They can't have caught her yet.
Will you turn the bloody radio off?
Oh, why? I like music while we're working.
Well, I don't. Watch it. Oh, what's the matter, Diddums? Don't get any ideas. I'm going to have you for breakfast, Milsom, and never even raise a burp.
Try me. Watch it. Someone's coming.
How's it going, ladies?
Oh, we've got job satisfaction just coming out of our backsides, Mr. Crookshank.
Don't push your luck, Winter.
Excuse me, Mr. Crookshank. What's the word on Reb?
She's in solitary for the moment.
Uh-huh. Well, does that mean that Cass will be coming back to us now that she's in the clear?
I'm afraid not, Judy. According to the hospital, she's not fit to be moved anywhere yet.
Oh, God. Well, you really put in a good day's work that day, didn't you?
He did say he wishes things had been different. That the baby had been his.
That'd be right. Well, it was worth a try. Hey, I bet old Cass was upset to hear about the baby. The way she was carrying on, you think she was having it?
Bobby, about Cass.
She's all right, isn't she?
No, she isn't. When she heard about your miscarriage, I'm afraid she just lost control. She tried to strangle an officer. She's had to be admitted to the state hospital for the criminally insane.
But Cass isn't crazy. You've got to get her out of there.
I'm sorry, Bobby, but she had a complete breakdown. Believe me, all we can do is hope that she gets better.
Wish I'd never got out of hospital. Wish I'd snuffed it. I've got nothing now. Nothing.
Do they reckon that Cass will get better?
It's hard to say with mental illness, but she is getting the best possible treatment.
Well, bloody hell, who's been stuffing around in here anyway?
It's your new cellmate. And Mrs. Reynolds thought it might be a good idea if you had someone to share with it. No, don't worry. I'll get her to clean it up for you.
You might feel better if she just cleared out. No one's going to take Cass's place.
Oh, you must be Bobby. I've heard all about you.
Yes, this is Marlene Warren. She's
I'm your new cellmate. Oh, gee, this should be great. I was afraid I'd get stuck in with a bunch of old biddies or something.
Wish you had if the place looks like a knock shop.
Yeah, will you tidy it up, please, and then get back to work? You all right?
Yeah. Hey, I heard about you losing the baby. That's real rough. Look, you and me can have a great time in here. I reckon stir up some of the misery Guts's talk about.
I'll drop off, will ya?
Look, I'm just trying to cheer you up. You look as if you've been to a funeral or something.
Shut your neck, all right?
Oh, I'm sorry, I wasn't thinking.
Stick your sympathy, just leave me alone.
Look, I just want to be mates.
You're going to be sleeping in the bed of the best mate I ever had until the stinking screws dragged her off. Back off before I do something I'll be really sorry for.
Speak of the devil. Heather's just been telling me about the set 2 and B block this morning.
Oh? And did she tell you what happened exactly?
Only that she was glad you were there.
Well, the feeling was mutual. She got the brawl under control whilst I was flat out on the floor.
Good for you. That should boost your confidence in handling the job.
Oh, well, there really wasn't any time to think about it. I just rushed in. But I was shaking like a leaf after it was over.
Well, it was good to see that your training came out under pressure. She used karate on them.
Oh, where did you learn that?
Oh, my dad. He reckoned that all girls should learn to look after themselves.
Wise father.
Yes.
I hear Dot Farrow was the cause of it all.
Again? That's why she was moved out of D block, wasn't it?
Yes, well, now she's being moved out of B block. You're getting her this afternoon.
You made my day.
So what do you think about putting her in with Judy Bryant?
Well, she'd be about the only one who could put up with her.
You wouldn't think an old lady like that would be such a troublemaker, would you?
Well, this one is. She's a born whinger.
That causes fights?
It does. When Dot gets going, she's got a habit of rubbing everyone up the wrong way.
Sounds like a real character. But how come someone that old still in prison anyway?
Oh, well, unfortunately, she's been in for so long, she's become institutionalized. If we let her out tomorrow, she'd do something to get back in the next day.
Oh, right. She's a I can never say that word.
Recidivist.
Yeah, that's it. Sad, though, isn't it? Being stuck behind bars for most of your life.
I don't think she sees it that way. To Dot, it's home.
Somehow, I can't see our lot welcoming her into the family, though.
Oh, morning, Miss Ferguson. How are you today?
Desmond been picked up yet?
No, but, Life has not been dull. Keane has owned up to clobbering Hunt.
Well, how about that? What's going to be done about it?
Well, she's in solitary at the moment, and, well, she'll face charges, of course.
So we're going to have Keane with us for quite some time yet, eh?
No, that we will. There was a bit of a brawl over in B Block this morning, too. Young Heather sorted it out. By all accounts, she handled herself like a true pro.
That's what she's paid to do.
Well, the upshot of that lot is that a prisoner named Farrah is being moved over to our block.
Oh, no. Dot Farrah. Well, between Farrah and that idiot Warren getting on everyone's goat, we're not going to have a moment's peace in this place.
What's this about Marlene?
Pardon?
Warren's my name. I'm Marlene's dad. She hasn't been getting herself in trouble, has she?
Mr. Crookshank will attend to you, Mr. Warren.
Now, what can we do for you?
Well, I came to see Marlene and bring her this, but maybe I should see the governor first. Can I do that?
Oh, I'll see if she's available, but don't fret yourself too much about Marlene. She'll settle in. Well, take a seat.
What do you think you're doing?
Making up me bed.
Well, I got news for you. This is my bed. What are you doing in here?
I'm Dot Farrah. Just come from B Block. You know what the screws are. Never leave you where you're comfortable.
Huh. Well, they've made a big mistake. I share with Myra Desmond.
Don't know about that. Thought she'd flown the coop.
Yeah, she had some business to attend to, but she's coming back.
Sounds a bit far-fetched to me. God, some people tell you anything, wouldn't they? You can't trust nobody these days.
Yes, I've noticed. You turn your back for 1 minute and they steal your bed.
Oh, don't be like that. Just that this seemed a bit more comfortable, and me being half crippled with rheumatics, my only pleasure's a good night's sleep. You don't mind, do you, love?
Yes, I do. You're not staying here. I mean, why did they send you from B Block in the first place?
It wasn't my fault. A lot of young buggers with no respect for their elders.
What's going on here? That's what I would like to know. I mean, what is she doing here? I told Mrs. Reynolds Mara will be back.
No doubt about you, Bryant. I bet you believe in the Easter Bunny, too.
She gave me her word, Miss Ferguson.
Oh, yeah, she'll be back when she's caught. But somehow I can't see the governor letting her share a cell with the person who helped her escape.
Looks like we're cellmates, hey? Oh, don't worry, love. I'm sure we'll be combustible.
Just so cold.
Grab the rug and put it round yourself, love. Coffee will help warm you.
Won't help. Nothing will help me.
How about some hot rolls and a couple of slices of your genuine Edam?
Sounds terrific. Here's your coffee, love.
It's not coffee I need. I'm going to town.
Okay.
Look, I won't go near any drugs. Just can't stand being cooped up in here.
Well, let's go for a walk. It's a lovely day outside.
Rack off, will ya? Look, I'm the one going through this hell, remember? You selfish bastards aren't helping any, hanging around like a couple of bad smells.
G'day, Dad.
Hi. Oh, you know we're not supposed to hug or nothing, but you know I'm glad you come, don't you?
Oh, of course I do. It's good to see you, love. How are you keeping? You know I've been a bit worried.
Oh, I'm fine. Hell, Dad, you know me. I'll do this standing on my head.
By the way, I've left a little prezzy for you at reception.
Oh, thanks, Dad. How's Mum?
Oh, she's okay, yeah. She just couldn't bring herself to come and see you in here. She's taking it a bit hard, you know.
Yeah, I thought she might.
But she sends her love and wants to know if there's anything you need.
Nah, you tell her I'll be back before she knows.
But how are you coping being in here, Ma?
Oh, I'm fine. Main problem is they all take themselves so bloody seriously. But I'm doing my bit to liven things up.
Yeah, I've heard all about all that from the governor. She seems a real nice lady, that Mrs. Reynolds, but she doesn't like you playing tricks on the other women.
Oh, it's just a bit of fun, Dad, you know that.
Of course I do, but like she says, some of these women have had a pretty rough trot and they're a bit short on a sense of humour.
So I better pull my neck in. I should think of something to take their minds off being in the joint.
Well, you watch your step, eh? Hey, I can remember when you organised all the neighbourhood kids into frisbees and I had to end up over about a dozen busted windows.
Yeah, it was fun, bud, eh?
And then it was skateboards until young Charlie Burton broke his leg.
Yeah, his mum really did a nana over that, didn't she? Wasn't my fault the kid couldn't handle it.
All the same, just watch what you're getting into, right?
Sure, Dad.
Well, I've got to be going now. I'll come and see you again soon.
Thanks, Dad. You know, I really miss you and Mum. You know that.
We miss you too, Ma. See ya, Ma.
Yeah. Bye.
Gorgeous, poor buggers. Haven't got much in here, have you? Mind you, I've heard about the way you all carry on. Guess they figured it'll get smashed up anyway. Table's seen some games. Mind you don't make a hole in it, love. Got some sociable ones round here, haven't we?
Yeah, we try. Bobby. Oh, hello, love. How are you feeling?
I'm all right.
Anything I can do?
No, it's all right.
You sure?
No.
So you're Bobby Mitchell, eh? That you was a tough little punk. Yeah, well, punk would be right in here.
How'd you like that cue shoved down your neck sideways?
Just watch the language around me, sweetie, or I'll give you an enema with...
Yeah, you and whose army?
Just me, sweetheart. Your mate's in the nut house, so you got no one to back you up, remember? Now, you lay off her, Murray. She's just out of hospital. Well, she better find out who's running things around here, or she'll end up back there quicker and she knows it.
Would you believe we're to play host to a television crew?
What for this time?
The department has agreed to let Nee Templar be interviewed.
Oh, after the Camilla Wells debacle.
That was my argument, but it didn't do any good. Approval came direct from the minister.
Oh, well, so did the orders for the security crackdown.
Exactly. Didn't one minute they want more security, the next it's TV interviews and special treatment for someone's favourite prisoner.
Looks like the powers that be are just going through one of their periodic bursts of stupidity. I mean, you just got to ride it out.
May not have to. I've got to please explain from the minister over a disastrous fate. He wants to see me tomorrow.
You just got to buck up and look on the bright side, Bobby.
Everybody I know had kids got nothing but trouble out of them.
Yeah, right. Look, you've come up smelling like roses. No crappy nappies to wash, no rotten little bugger screaming its head off all night long.
Rack off, Marlene.
Look, you've got to learn to take it easy.
Why don't you go and get some more dirty laundry and leave the kid alone?
I'm not nagging you, am I? I'm just trying to cheer you up. You can't let a thing like a miscarriage ruin your whole life.
Oh, God, are you in more islands?
Well, well. A little punk's got a temper.
Ignore her. Come on, honey, I'll give you a hand here. How's that? He looks so screwed up.
I don't want it.
Hey, you've got to try and eat something.
You've had nothing since you came here.
So?
Well, you can't play footy on an empty stomach.
Please, Kay, try and get something inside you.
Shove it! I can't do it, Mum. I can't.
You can.
But you don't know what it's like.
I know damn well you won't hit 20 unless you get off it.
So what? It's my life, not yours.
You want to see me, Governor?
Yes. Sit down. I thought you'd be interested to know that I have to report to the department tomorrow with an explanation for what happened at the fete.
Hardly any of my business, Governor.
No. A friend of mine tells me it was a report from you that led to this meeting.
I'm a senior officer, Governor. I have a right to make a report.
I'm aware of an officer's rights, Miss Ferguson. But you saw fit to give details of my personal life.
I don't follow you.
That's because you're so far ahead of me. How dare you accuse me of having, and I quote, an improper personal relationship with Dr. Edmonds?
The department has a right to know what's going on.
Not in my personal life, it doesn't, and neither do you. You're hardly a fit person to decide what is or is not proper.
In my experience, Governor, relationships between staff members have a bad effect on discipline.
What happened between Dr. Edmonds and myself had nothing whatsoever to do with the way we conducted our duties here.
and it was none of your business.
Whatever you say, Governor.
In future, I suggest you confine your duties to matters that concern you.
Will that be all?
Yes.
By the way, Governor, since you've been receiving information, I think there's something you should know.
Oh?
Well, none of us can be sure how you'll get on tomorrow, but just in case, I have already prepared my application for the position of Governor.
Hello. How's your tummy?
All right. Geez, Jude, I was only trying to cheer her up, and what do I get? An elbow in the guts.
Yeah. Well, I think I believe that you didn't mean any harm. It's just that you've got to try and understand what Bobby's doing.
I'm trying to, but she's got to try and get over it.
That's going
to
take her a very long time. Bobby's had a really rotten life. You know that they told her she'd never have a baby? That's why this baby was so important to her.
No, I didn't know that. Well, I'll be careful in future, but geez, if I don't get a laugh while I'm in here, I'm going to go up the wall.
Rabbit, we all like to have a good laugh, but you've got to get to know us first. Pick your marks more carefully.
Well, I will. But I've got to play jokes on people. It's just the way I am. Tell when they backfire, but...
Yes, I'm sure it is. But I wouldn't worry too much. Bobby will get over it.
I wasn't talking about her.
Oh?
I was acting a fool. Got me in here.
What happened?
Me and a couple of mates chucking rocks at cars on freeways.
Oh, my God. Don't you realise how dangerous that is?
No, not till one broke a windscreen. The guy swerved and hit a pole. Got killed. I never wanted that to happen.
I'm sure you didn't. Well, you're going to have to think your little plans through a bit more, aren't you?
Yeah, I'll try. But the problem is they just come to me on the spur of the moment.
And look where it's landed you. Now, if you're going to play jokes around here and they're going to backfire, somebody's going to get hurt.
Well, another day down.
Yes, I can't say I'm sorry to see the end of this one.
Aye. From what I've heard, you've had your fair share of excitement.
I could use another word for it.
Well, Mrs. Morris told me that that set two in B block could have turned ugly if it hadn't been for you. Congratulations. You did well.
Thank you. Let's just say I did something right for a change. I'll see you later.
Are you doing out this evening?
Out? I don't think I know what out is. What is it?
Oh, you know what I mean. No, it's all right. I'm not trying to line you up.
What did you have in mind then?
Well, there's only myself at home, and well, it's no fun eating by yourself. How would you like to have a bite to eat with me? There's a little restaurant just down the road. It's two workmates, new at the job, eh? We talk shop all night.
Okay, but on one condition.
What's that?
That we go Dutch.
We split eighties in Yorkshire, lass. I'll not argue on that score.
Okay.
Okay.
Why don't you face it? She's worse than a chronic toothache.
Oh, look, will you give it a rest? I've had a talk to her. She's going to be all right if you just give her a chance.
She raves on like she's wound up or something.
Oh, come on, give her a chance, okay?
Uh-oh, here comes a Wentworth whinger.
Them little gits from the server need their bums tanned. Huh? I tell you, we had a lot more respect for each other in B block.
Why don't you put him for a transfer back? We wouldn't mind.
Oh, no, that'll be enough out of you too. Why don't you go somewhere else and let us oldies get on with it?
Hey, you bow. I'm not ready for the old age pension just yet.
Yeah, believe it or not, I've got a couple of years to go, dear.
You'll have to forgive me, dear. My eyesight's not the best. I just have to go on the focal tones.
Ah, oh, boy.
Bobby? Yeah? I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'll take it easy in future, okay? Okay.
Good. Potatoes again. Always bloody potatoes. They've got no imagination in that kitchen.
Well, they're good for you. I just finished reading this diet where you can eat as many spuds as you like as long as you get regular exercise.
Oh, yeah? Well, I've left my run a bit late.
You have got a bit of a podge there, dear. Mustn't let ourselves go to seed just because we're over the hill now, should we?
Oh, g'day.
Well, what have you been up to today?
Not much. I washed the dishes, swept up a bit, you know.
Oh, looks as though you did a pretty good job, too. Where's Nicky?
He's running around. I gave him his tea, but he didn't eat much.
Oh, well, he'll eat when he's hungry. I went to see your father today.
It's no good sending me back. I'll only nick off again. I hate his guts.
Come on, you don't really mean that.
Too right I do. He's never done nothing for me. He's only got time for his grog.
Shane, he is your father.
I can get along better without him.
Yeah, well, I haven't been able to make any other arrangements for you, so... looks as though you'll be spending another night here.
Yeah? Beauty.
They're a mixed bunch, really. Bryant seems like a real softie, but I've heard you can be pretty tough. But what about Winter?
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. She's troubled, that one. Mm. But tell me, how did a nice slice like you come to be a prison officer in the first place?
Oh, well, you see, my dad was a cop, so that's what I wanted to be. But I flunked out.
How did your dad take it?
Oh, he didn't. He died a couple of years ago.
Oh, sorry, Heather, that's tough.
Yeah, he was one of the best. Well, after I failed to make the police force, I saw this ad for a prison officer. So I thought, Rogers, this could be it.
And you're not sorry?
No. I'll make it. Don't you worry. I've told you all about me. What's your dark secret?
It's not all that dark. No, I was married for years, but... it just didn't work in the end.
I'm divorced.
No. It was her idea, not mine.
Well, perhaps you could try again. There's always Miss Ferguson, you know.
Nicky! Where the hell are you, you stupid mutt?
Hey, Shane, keep your voice down. You'll have the neighbours after us.
He usually comes straight away.
Oh, all right, I'll go and get a torch. He might be just caught up somewhere.
Nicky! Miss Ferguson, quick!
God, Shane, he's been poisoned.
No, Nicky. He can't die.
Look, he won't die. We'll get him to the vet straight away. Nick, you just stay with him and I'll call a taxi.
Nicky, you can't die on me. Nicky.
You're the lucky one.
Oh, g'day. I made a mistake. I just thought this was my cell. I come in and found this.
Yeah, you made a mistake, all right. Now I'm going to give you lesson number one in keeping your nose out of other people's business.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare awake. the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.